Well, that is a brand new sign out here, and that is a monorail track. Fortunately, no monorails on it. Except for over here. Look at that. Oh, it is beautiful. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the experimental prototype community of tomorrow. We're here for an amazing day. I'm so excited. There's so much to do. Flower and Garden is back, which is weird because I was here 2 years ago for Flower and Garden, but they have some new food, so we're going to try those. And then, yeah, just have a great day. It's good to be at Epcot as always. Let's get today started. I also decided to finally get a Magic Band Plus, mainly to test it out. And I know I'm going to get multi-use of it because at some point I know I'm going to visit Disneyland. And so I know they're using those there. So might as well, you know. So we'll test some of that stuff out. I know the 50th anniversary is ending. So a lot of stuff's going away. But, you know, at the same time, it's worth a look. We'll see how it goes. It's weird. This is probably the earliest I've been to Epcot in a very long time. It's currently 8 o'clock. It's not even time for early park entry yet. It's not even time for me to enter the park. We still got like an hour to wait. But there is no one else over on this side. You got a couple people over behind. Ooh. Got a monorail going by, which is super cool. And honestly, like, the weather right now is really nice, which compared to the other day at Hollywood Studios is definitely a plus. So very thankful for that. Unfortunately, today is my last day here in Florida. I was down here for the Exponential Conference, which was for church planters and church leaders. It was super good. Maybe I'll have a chance to talk about it at some point down the road. But this is my last day here in the parks, and I don't know when I'll be back here. I said that last time, but I really don't know the next time I'm going to be back here. I may take a little break from Walt Disney World. I want to try some new things. Some of those things are up and coming literally within a couple of months, which is a little like, it's weird to say because part of me is like, I want to come back to Walt Disney World because you got Happily Ever After that's coming back, which is one of my favorite shows of all time. Then you got Tron and a lot of stuff. You got the Center of Epcot will be done, you know, within the next year or so, but looking to see some more Disney adventures to come. I'm very excited for those when those do happen. Well, I can stare at Spaceship Earth pretty much all day. They have added our friends from Encanto to the front of Flower and Garden. And dude, these look fantastic in person. I didn't realize this was towards the front of the park. And so I knew these were coming. But man, oh man, do they look fantastic. Like seriously, they look so, so good. I think it's time to spark our creativity with a little imagination. I hope to be enlightened. De nada.
With LIGHT, you can see things differently. Sure, you can see with your eyes, but imagine what you could see if you used your imagination. We'll go to my open house instead. It's much more fun. Right this way, everybody.
What is going on? Turning this entire open house upside down.
Upside down? Now you're talking. That's the best idea you've had all day. With just a spark of inspiration. And
he's looking a little stiff.
Oh, as you can plainly see, imagination works the best when it's set free.
You said it, Doc. Imagination is a blast.
Enlightenment. My imagination can go anywhere except reality. You know, funny enough, for all the times that I've come to Epcot and specifically Flower and Garden, I didn't get a chance to do the butterfly landing. So that's what we're gonna do right now, to go take a little adventure there. That's cool, though. I like that. You can actually see over in this box some of the cocoons of some of the butterflies here. Pretty cool. So that was fun. It was pretty cute. We're going to make our way over into the land just for a quick little peek around. Soren's currently at a 40-minute wait. It's not terrible, but you know what? I wouldn't mind a flight around the world, so we're going to take care of that. Take care of that now.
Hello, and welcome to Soren. My name is Patrick, and I'll be your chief flight attendant today. We'll be getting boarding in a few minutes, but first I'd like to acquaint you with some important safety information. When the doors to your flight open, please take a seat and store all carry-on items in the underseat compartment. This includes cameras, purses, hats, and of course, these little movies. Soar into tower. We are ready for takeoff.
Oh boy, here we go. Such an amazing time. We literally got, I think, the best seats because we were center top. So the front row and the center of that row. I mean, it was awesome to see. And granted, you know, I'm not the biggest person when it comes to heights. Next stop is, it is, you know, getting towards lunchtime. So that means it's time to enjoy some of the food around, of course, the International Flower and Garden Festival, which I'm very much looking forward to. So we're gonna head out of here, and we're gonna do that right now. Here in line at the Honey Bistro, heard there's a chicken and waffles that is really, really good. So we're gonna try it. Had a chance to have the chicken and waffles, and it is really, really good. Chicken has like a spicy flavor to it. Waffle is a cornbread, which is very interesting, but it fits very well with the food. It's good. We're gonna move on though. We're gonna go over to Pineapple Promenade. Believe it or not, I've actually never had the Violet Lemonade, so we're gonna have that. Then we're gonna continue around the World Showcase. Just had the Violet Lemonade. It's honestly really solid. Not a flavor I was 100% expecting, but it is pretty good. It's a good drink. I don't think it's necessarily my favorite. You know, I enjoy lemonade, but it's not my favorite. But overall, it is quite good. Over here in China, they have a spicy chicken skewer. We're gonna go ahead and try, see if it's any good. So I got to try the spicy chicken skewer over here in the China Pavilion. I gotta tell you, it looks good, but it's kind of disappointing, if I'm being honest. Peanut sauce is a little weird. maybe just chicken and peanut. It's odd. But the bummer is like there's not really a spice to it. It's called the spicy chicken skewer, but it's not spicy at all. Like, I'm pretty sure people who absolutely hate spice can like 100% handle it. I don't know, it was very disappointing. Hey look, they still have phones. Let's check to see if anyone's there. Hello? Mickey? No, he didn't say. Sorry. Alright, next up is Germany. We're going to be trying the toasted pretzel bread and the Stiegel Brewery Radler Raspberry. It sounds interesting. So we're going to try both those things and see how they are. So, of course, went to Germany and had the Stiegel raspberry drink, as well as, of course, the toasted pretzel bread. That's definitely been the best stop so far here in the World Showcase. The pretzel bread was delicious. It was good. The ham was a little, like, together, which was fine. It was all good, really, really good. And then the Stiegel raspberry drink was really, really, really good. I'm a fan of raspberry drinks, and to have kind of a more adult drink for that was really, really good. So I enjoyed it. We interrupt our tour of the World Showcase and eating food for a little trip into outer space. So, Cosmic Rewind is great as always. Man, that was good. We got Disco Inferno, which is cool. Still waiting on Everyone Wants to Rule the World, but I do have virtual queue for later, so I may have a chance to finally get that song in, hopefully. Well, welcome back to the World Showcase. It's weird, we're starting over on this side towards Canada, because it's one of the last food booths I want to check out for stuff. So I'm breaking tradition by going right instead of left. Feels weird. We are here to try two things, the beef tenderloin tips and the chocolate maple whiskey cake. Both sound delicious. So we're gonna try it. So I had the beef tenderloin, or tenderloin tips. It's good value for what you get. You get a little bit of carrots, so you got some vegetables. You get some potatoes, so you get a little food. And that was really, really good. That might be, so far, the best food item I've had here at the Flower and Garden Festival. Now onto the chocolate cake. It's really good. Didn't realize there was maple in it, which kind of adds a little extra uniqueness to it. But it's really, really good as well, for sure. So far, this did beat Germany, in my opinion, as the best food booth, and it had the line to prove it. It was a pretty long line, probably the longest I've waited in, but it was worth it because it was delicious. Also, it's kind of nice. There's a ton of cloud coverage, and so you get a pretty view of the World Showcase from here. All the people coming around, eating some food. Maybe we'll check out the Canada stores real quick. I don't think we've done that together, so let's do that. If you guys aren't aware, I've been trying to find something at each pavilion that my heritage is from. So I'm like primarily German, French, Canadian. So I have a German hat from the Germany pavilion. And I want to find something from Canada, but it's super difficult to like try to find. Plus, the fact that I have a very small bag makes it very, very difficult to pick up some of this stuff. But definitely want something to kind of commemorate a little bit of my heritage. Honestly, there's some pretty good stuff, but it's just like, I don't know. Like, part of me likes it, part of me doesn't. That's different. So a very interesting spirit jersey. Hold on. Let me pull it down. I don't really do this, but that's kind of unique. I don't think I'll get it. It's kind of weirdly two-toned. Ugh, trying to put that back up. Ooh, caffeine. Got some caffeine, found an Epcot one. But that does not count for Canada. It all depends on what I can fit in my backpack, since we did fly a budget airline. And I'm not paying 70-something dollars for a bag. Unfortunately, couldn't find anything there that, like, I absolutely needed. There was a cool t-shirt in there that I may get at some point, but again, I came with limited items. Yes. The United Kingdom Pavilion. Honestly, I think this is a very underrated one. I may need to do a ranking of the World Showplay or World Showcase pavilions at some point. Ooh, look at that. You got our friends from the 100 Acre Wood up here. Okay. I did not know this. Everybody stay calm. But they have Monty Python shirts here. It's not a Disney movie, but they have Monty Python stuff. Look, nobody expects the Spanish Inquisition. Let's not figure and argue over who killed who. Keep calm and buy a shrubbery. Spam, egg, sausage, spam. Just a flesh wound. That's awesome. This is so weird. Casting Crowns is coming here at some point. But they're playing their song, Only Jesus, right now. And I am happy about it. Oh, man. That's so weird. Also, Switchfoot will be here at some point. Would be cool to hear Casting Crowns right now, not gonna lie. I've seen them once in concert. But tonight, it looks like Tommy DiCarlo. And with us officially making our way around the World Showcase, I think we accomplished a lot. We got to eat at several of the food booths. We got to try some new things. We only got to try a few drinks and stuff. But overall, I feel pretty accomplished for what we were able to do with Flowering Garden. This is why I think Epcot is so awesome at night. Like, don't get me wrong, I love Magic Kingdom at night. Hollywood Studios at night is very close second because of the neon lights. But dude, I don't think you can get any better than that. You can't. I don't think you can at all.
Tiny little seat that's reaching up to meet your need. Let's listen to the nature's plan will shine. Listen to the land. Listen to the land. One little spark lights up for you. Imagination. Imagination. A dream can be a dream come true. With just that spark in me and you.
To the joy and through the tears.
Now that was cool. I'm going to stand here, wait for, of course, the 1-4 Flower and Garden. I heard it's Encanto themed. So we're going to stick around for that. That was awesome. I had a great day here at Epcot. Flower and Garden was awesome. Guardians of the Galaxy was awesome. It was just a really good Epcot day. Again, I don't know the next time I'll be back, but we do have some exciting stuff coming in the future. I'll see you all in the next video. Goodbye.